Welcome to Honolulu TV. Tonight we have some special guests from Boney M.
Boney M. Ett av världens absolut mäktigaste band. Kommentarer är egentligen totalt överflödiga. Bandet är så mäktigt så att de åker kors och tvärs över jordklotet. Och ibland möter de ett annat Boney M. Bandet är nämligen så mäktigt så att det finns ju flera simultana upplagor som åker kors och tvärs över jordklotet och får folk att korka upp. Över till intervjun.
What did you think about the show tonight? Was it fun?
It always is fun, but sometimes more than others, and tonight is one of the great fun nights. Great audience.
It looked like you really had fun up there.
Yeah, we did. We usually do, and we did.
And I think it shows like the happiness and the spontaneity. It must keep you like really interested night after night to do it, because anything can happen, obviously.
Yeah, it has to be impulsive, and the band is like, it's the nature of the group anyway, that even the songs dictate that, so
yeah.
it comes naturally to do it spontaneously.
You've been doing this since like 75?
Yeah.
It was your first stint in Boney M?
Yeah. So it's actually, this isn't the original setup. I must make that clear for people watching, but I am a one-time member of the band. So
yeah.
I was there from the very beginning and for a time after, and with Maisie Williams, Boney M. So, I'm a part of the history.
Yeah.
And a very nice history it is as well, but there's ups and downs with everything.
Yeah. There's been quite a few incarnations of the band with different members, and was it because of animosity amongst you guys?
Well, there's always animosity in every setup. You don't find that many bands staying together. But it's inevitable, really.
Yeah.
So, you all love each other when you're with each other. And then, unfortunately, the ego takes over. And the ego is a killer, unfortunately. That's with every band, really, not just with Boney M, but, 9 out of 10 bands would have a story like that to tell.
Yeah.
But it's the music that goes on.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily the people, it's the music that goes on. And that's the important thing. And it's Frank Farian's creation.
Yeah.
He doesn't get enough thanks, I feel. It's the four people as well, but it's without him there would be no Boney M. So I feel he should get more recognition.
Yeah.
That's my honest opinion, and I can only be honest.
Is it Frank Farian who dictates what it's like rules and regulations playing in Boney M? What you can't do or what you can't do?
Yeah, it is more or less him and his company. It is more or less him and and the record company Sony BMG. It is, but it's pretty free, as long as there are some rules you got to follow. You can't record any of his songs really without his permission and things like that. But otherwise, you can do things around it. But the main thing is just to play the music, to perform the music, and hopefully bring joy by doing that. And I think this is what we achieve. All the formations achieve that.
Yeah. So how many incarnations of Boney M is touring right now?
Do you know, it's really hard to say, but not as many as ABBA's. Hear that there's 301 ABBA's out there.
Yeah.
So we're a little drop in the ocean compared to your ABBA. But there's, I think, recognised Boney M incarnation to perform the music of Boney M is maybe six.
Yeah.
And so, as I said, compared to ABBA, that's actually not many. And for the popularity of the music, it should even, you know, I mean, I'm not saying it should be more, but it that's actually accepted because the music is so popular. You can't be everywhere in the world.
No.
There can't be just one original formation.
Of course, of course.
Portraying Boney M's music. So yeah, there needs to be some reincarnations.
And I think one of the reasons is the music transcends. It's you get like anywhere from Jamaican like hymns, spiritual songs, to country rock,
yeah,
and everything goes into that Boney M funnel.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, that's a good way to describe it. I wouldn't have described it like that. You did it better than me. And in my mother tongue as well.
Yeah.
Oh, let me try and say that in Swedish. I don't think I could. Yeah, that's true. You see, the brains behind it, as I said, Frank Farian, gave it careful thought, gave the whole thing careful, and thought of doing songs in so many different different stories covering a lot of the world. And so he made hits all around the world. It's partly money-making as well, but it's also, you know, just clever workmanship, really. So you're right, yeah. It's one band that you can't say it's a rock band, a pop band, you know, because we just cover everything. Rock, as you said, a lot of Caribbean things, though. Mainly that's the root of it, really.
Sämsta Sveriges 30 bästa hårdrocksband och artister genom tiderna-listorna i Sweden Rock Magazine. Mark Frostenäs lista. Morgana Le Fay, Talisman, Europe, Treat, Lost Horizon, Alien, Nocturnal Rites, Tad Moroz, First Raider, Heat, Candlemass, Yngwie Malmsteen, Hardcore Superstar, Seventh Wonder, Crystal Eyes, Memory Garden, Therion, Hammerfall, Supreme Majesty, Wolf, House of Shakira, Crystal Blue, John Norum, Damned Nation, Portrait, Vene Domine, Evergrey, Act, In Flames, Quill. Pelle Gunnarssons lista. Edge of Sanity, Crash Diet, Witchcraft, Ghost, Treat, November, Dozer, Count Raven, Switchblade, Yngwie Malmsteen, Europe, Nomads, Entombed, Pussy Galore, Heavy Load, Unicorn, Helicopters, Skin Trade, Marduk, Jam Session, Switch Open, Opeth, EF Band, Candlemass, Easy Action, Talk of the Town, Niflheim, Haunted, Talisman, Batane. John Jontens lista. Soilwork, Meshuggah, Last View, In Flames, Opeth, Ghost, Vildhjärta, Path of No Return, Pain, Totalt Jävla Mörker, Koma, Haunted, Jesaja, Edge of Sanity, Cult of Luna, Sonic Syndicate, Burst, At the Gates, Catatonia, Clawfinger, Walking with Strangers, Machine Supremacy, This Heaven, Scar Symmetry, Graveyard, A Time, Hammerfall, Dissection, Nasum, Victims.
Carlos, were you born in Jamaica too?
No, but very close, you know.
Yeah, very close, like thousands, millions of times.
No, but I
he's Jamaican.
Jamaican.
Thank you, Angela.
Oh. is this? Yeah, but very close. No, it is close. Close to heart, soul.
You guys all live in England now?
Yeah, we do. We all do live there, yeah. And I used to live in Germany, as you know. We lived in Denmark as well.
Yeah, you moved around quite a bit.
Yeah, I have done, actually. Now I am in England permanently. Yeah.
Your Swedish ain't too shabby either.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Förstår? Förstår.
Tack. Välkomna till märkligheten. Än en gång ska vi blanda en shot. Och den här shoten, det kan vara min favoritshot all time. Både på grund av dess historiska mäktighet och på grund av att den är så jävla god. Ja, jag vet att du också tycker. Sluta, håll inte på. Ja, i alla fall. Nu är det dräparen. Även kallad CP. Även kallad Christer Pettersson. Det är palmemördarens favoritdrink som ska blandas. Det har en viss mystik. Ja. Först tar man fram flaskan med Smirnoff. Den bästa spriten som finns att tillgå i Sverige. Den är trippeldestillerad. Därav ingen bakfylla. Vi häller på rikligt, som sig bör. Ja, jag är inte på mig. Sen 50% Smirnoff, 50% Baileys. Det kan bli ett lite skev fördelning nu, för att man gillar ju spriten. Den är så god. Nu är den klar. Palmemördarens favoritdrink. Dräpan. Christer Pettersson. Var han skyldig? Eller var han oskyldig? Kommer vi aldrig att få reda på. Tänk på det. Nästa gång. Kära vänner, vad kan jag säga annat än godnatt? Ja, där satt den.
Is Bonium big in Britain?
Do you know what? I don't think that. No. No. Not as big as Scandinavia. No. The songs are known, but not as popular. Obviously, if you do venues like then, and it's that 70s night or 80s,
yeah.
They go wild. They go wild. But generally, it's not. We're not as popular as places like this.
Yeah.
In terms of filling out a room or something, not so much anymore. I'm not sure why that is, actually, but.
Ilan! new albums, and I'd like you to tell me your favorite songs from
okay.
The albums.
All right.
The first one.
That one is actually not bad. The theme to the main song, "Take the Heat of Me," is a really nice song. For such an old album, it's actually got something nice about it. Nice. There's a timelessness about some of these songs where it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But there's something. That's just my taste, though.
And like it starts out with "Daddy Cool," which is like the opener of all openers.
Yeah, yeah. It seems to be. Which one's your favorite?
Are you a DJ or?
Sorry?
Are you a DJ? You play music?
I play sometimes.
Yeah? You play Bonnie Anne?
Yeah.
He's interested in you now.
Yeah, turn it around.
This one is my favorite, actually.
Oh, you mean from all of them? The album, actual albums?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean? The favorite from all the albums?
Yeah, this is my favorite.
Oh, I get you. Yeah, everybody likes that one.
Yeah. Because my parents had this.
There's some very unusual tracks on that as well.
Yeah, you get "Heart of Gold."
That's a beautifully sung by Liz. Yeah. That's a beautiful ballad, yeah. It never got into the charts, really. Well, not high, and it should have done. It was beautifully done, I must admit.
I really like that one.
Nice.
You got any other favorites to perform aside from what you showed us tonight?
Oh, what do you guys like?
I like Mary's Boy Child.
Yeah. Oh, I do see a lot of people like that.
I love that. I love that song.
I love Fever. You guys have done Fever. Oh God, it's so catty. Fever, yeah. And their version is nice. Their version is nice of Fever, I must say. So we might do that.
And it suits you. Yeah. That is a nice one.
I like Calvin Badalina. Do you like Calvin Badalina? Yeah, yeah. Get it? I like them all in this way. I don't get the last one, the last, I don't get the Christmas album on LP, and I do not got the album with just an I.
I dance. I think that one's "I Dance," you know.
Yeah.
That wasn't that popular, but some things on it, some people know it, but it wasn't as popular as some of those.
I mean, I heard it, but I don't think it was sort of, the popularity was declining there for a while.
Yeah, I think that was when it started to decline, maybe early or middle 80s.
Yeah.
With the "I Dance," I don't even know myself, early 80s, I think. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that.
She was like, "You're not Seth Green." I was like, "How do you know?" And she was like, "Because we're on a public bus in Milwaukee. You are not Seth Green." It's like, kudos, lady. What you lack in tact, you make up for in logic. Bravo. You win. So I found out I'm really bad at gift giving. Like, I'm really bad, and it's not because I'm a bad person, it's because I'm poor. Like, that's why. But like, I'll go to those free book bins in the library and I'll be like, "Oh, Nora Roberts' romance novel. My 26-year-old heterosexual male cousin will love this shit. Let's load it up." You know, like, that's what I'll do. And the other day, my dad gave me a razor, like a razor that he won, right? And he gave it to me, and he's like, "One condition." And I was like, "What's that?" And he's like, "Father's Day is coming up. I don't want to see this again." He gave me the razor, like, under the condition I didn't re-gift it to him. Which is great. That blew my mind, right? Because I didn't know Father's Day was a gift-giving holiday.
Where is this tour heading?
Home. Home? No, tomorrow is... Do you know, I can't remember the name of it, but it's 2 hours from here. It's tomorrow's show. But I don't know the name.
Is it Sweden?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We got one more day here in Sweden.
Okay.
And then back to London. I go to Spain. I have to record, so I have to finish some... I'm doing an album. I'm doing an album called Angel Cures. It's finished. It's just to put tiny touches on and slice
shorten some tracks. So that's what I've got to do there. We all do our separate solo things as well.
So what do you guys do when you're not doing Boney M?
Ladies first.
He's so polite.
I'm trying.
Impeccable manners. That's very important.
I'm learning to play guitar.
Right.
And I write and record my own songs as well.
Alright, cool.
Shyla gives me a lot of support with that as well. It's lovely.
Yeah. With pleasure.
How's it going with the guitar playing then?
Sorry?
How's it going with the guitar playing?
With what, sorry?
With the guitar playing.
It's okay, I can play a song.
Yeah?
A few, just simple strums, and I sing as well. So, and I kind of like do a lot of acoustic stuff.
Yeah?
And a bit of
got the right
R&B. Yeah. I have to keep my nails short. That's why they're so short, so that I can play.
You got those calluses yet?
Oh.
It's nearly there.
Oh.
Nearly.
Let me feel.
Is it too?
That's what they say.
It's coming along.
You need to work on it, girl.
I know, it's a bit too soft, isn't it?
It should go like this.
Yeah, it's very painful when I can't play for too long because it's very painful.
Mm. And that's why when you build it up, it's like not.
You get callous. So you get like hard skin. When you play for long,
it
and it doesn't pain anymore. Yeah.
Oh, that's what Fluff says.
You can. I was thinking that maybe you could buy stuff to put on your fingers to stop it, but the guitarist didn't know. That's a real guitarist doesn't do that. They have to build up the hard skin.
I guess it's the nature of the beast.
Right? Yeah, exactly.
Carlos.
Oh yeah. I shall. I said everyone is working in something, you know.
Yeah,
I'm playing the guitar as well.
You should talk about your book.
When I met Kira, she promised me to teach me how to sing because I don't know how to sing.
Oh,
I'm gonna do some recording with him. He can sing.
Of course he can.
And,
he can.
Obviously, you can sing.
He can sing.
Better than
Bobby.
You know, I'm trying, but I know that I can do better. Someone shows me what I have to do because I just go in the live, you know, and she got some techniques.
You're doing very
and when
well.
I met, because I was like,
I'm gonna sing, very well.
I can sing. Oh,
Jesus. I'm gonna record it.
Sing a little bit like
that
them.
Love,
yeah.
Then you can sing more
exactly.
I'm playing as a DJ as well in different places.
All right.
Yeah.
What kind of music do you?
I play a lot of R&B, hip-hop, soul, and house music.
Right.
It's my favorite to mix R&B, because when you go R&B, you go like...
Have you got the same taste?
And then you push it in a house stuff, it's like bang, 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 relax with the R&B. Go ahead, bang, bang, house, I guess. And of course, music, and music. We just
live
music.
And breathe music.
Yes. Yeah. And writing as well.
Yeah.
Oh, I've got a book. Yeah, it's called... Women are like cats and men like dogs, or are they? And it's a relationship book. It's a shame I didn't bring any copies, actually. I could have given you a free... Yeah, but it's not for men.
Okay. You can. Of course it is.
But I don't know.
Go on, plug your book.
That's it. So, Age of Cures and the book.
You can find it on like Amazon or...
Yes, you can, actually. Yeah. Oh, your poem. You've done a book of poems.
Yeah, I just released a book as well.
You too.
See, Boney M, people are talented. It's not just by the rivers of Babylon. Sorry.
Okay. Our time is up.
All right. Thank you.
I would like to thank you very much for doing this, and I hope you come back soon.
Thank you. Yeah, whenever you say, if we're free, it would be a pleasure.
Yeah.
All right then.
Thank you.
Taksimiki. Hey, doll.
Taksimiki.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is a story about how this is a story
about Africa.
The meanest kept for going to town.
Smoke to us.
dead. Oh, she was really tough. She was the most pathetic. He wasn't tough enough. She took her boys along, but they were mean and strong. Hey, I make up. She taught her four sons.
Yeah.